What's the deal, y'all? This your man, King Harry, the media assassin, coming at y'all with another video. And I found this video pretty interesting because this is a part of my forte. This podcaster interviewer that goes by the name of Bootleg Kev, he did an interview with this artist named EST. I didn't know too much about Bootleg Kev other than the Mac-10 interview he did recently. I will chime in on that later on, but I didn't know nothing about this other dude he was interviewing. He go by the name of EST. So I went ahead and I heard a lot of people talking about it. It's gone viral that he walked out on the interview. I'm like, okay, what is going on? Why he walked out on the interview? So I'm watching the interview, and first things first, I noticed that it was just an awkward vibe at all. Even when EST was just talking about his album, he didn't really seem interested at all. And you could tell Kev was trying to get answers out of him. Something clearly happened before the interview started. I don't know if it was an argument. I don't know if it was, but the situation was tense. So then he tries to go in on his NFL career, or you know, his football background, and dude just got mad, walked out. Now, let me tell y'all this, man. Interviewing these artists is a tough job. And sometimes these artists do not give you a lot of layers to work with. They just want you to talk about the album. But at the same time, you got to give people a story because, you know, we're in the content game. Him just talking about an album ain't going to really get content because people don't care about music. They want, in a way, in the content game, they want fuckery. They want car crashes. They want controversy. They want fights. So Kev, he's in the content game. I can't knock him for that. He's trying to get views. He's trying to get an interesting interview out of this guy. And what I think what happened, because now I'm finding out that he was 2 hours late, according to what Kev said after the show, he was 2 hours late. So what I think of what happened, he's seeing that the vibe is not there. He figured, okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to antagonize this guy so I could at least either have him try to attack me or walk out. That alone is going to give me views. And that's exactly what happened. Now, the Bootleg Kev show is going to go up to another level because people love controversy. They love the car crash. They love the confrontation. Music is not going to sell no more, unfortunately. It should be a talking point in the right world of doing sense of journalism, but this is not the way this works now. People only pay attention to 3 to 5 minute clips, and this clip right here is more interesting than probably than the whole interview. So artists gotta pretty much look at themselves, and you gotta kind of in a way check your ego at the door and be able to know what's being handled, because this, the football thing, it looked like it was a harmless question, but if he didn't want to talk about it, he should have just respected it. I think it what happened, he wanted to push that line because he was 2 hours late. So he was like, all right, man, you don't waste my time. So I'm going to try to antagonize you or agitate you. So you can either put your hands on me, you can cuss me out, or you can walk out. And I'm going to go viral off that, which is what happened. Now, his stock done elevated. Check the game. His stock done elevated. EST, on the other hand, he's going to look like a crybaby. He's not going to be able to get interviews out. People are not going to want to talk with him just based off that clip alone. People are going to be like, oh, he's going to be hard to interview. I don't want him on my show. You got to learn how to handle media, y'all. When y'all going on these press runs, y'all got to learn how to handle media. Not because you like these guys, but also the fact that the way you talk to media can make or break your career. So this is exactly what he did. He did that to agitate him because he felt he lost on his investment. And then he recouped on it. Now the show is going viral. Everybody's commenting on it. He's on TMZ. Vlad is commenting on it. It's everywhere. So it was a smart move. But in the long run, we're going to see how far it takes him, because Kev is not a bad interviewer in comparison to these to his peers, but he has a tendency of trying to antagonize or, you know, antagonize, not antagonize, but initiate shit for clicks. Just like when I watched the Mac 10 interview. He tried to ask the Cypress Hill question, and Mac called him on that. He was like, yo, you were slick with that one. I'm like, dude, everybody knows what happened with Cypress Hill and West Side Connection. You don't need to keep on revisiting that wheel. Anybody that knows about that, they could just look on YouTube on Beef 2. Or just listen to the records. You don't need to keep revisiting the wheel. And that's what these people try to do. But let me know what you guys think in the comments, man. Was he right for walking out? Was Kev wrong? Let me know. Holla.